Hello, my name is Nina Feber, and I am a PhD student at the Czech Technical University in Prague, Faculty of Civil Engineering. And here I'm going to talk about the behavior of austenitic stainless steel beam columns. Generally, my work is to comprehend the behavior of stainless steel members loaded by compression plus bending. I focus on study of relevant interaction factors for welded open section beam columns. Actually, the presentation contents, as you can see, is two main points of my research. The first one is the description of the performed experiments, including the material test and initial imperfection measurements. And then I'd like to show you the numerical models which were developed and validated against the experimental results. And of course, I couldn't skip the existing codes and performed research in this field. Nowadays, there are several ways to determine the bearing capacity of members which are subjected to bending and axial compression. First, the Eurocode 1993 Part 1.1, which provides the general rules for steel structures. However, stainless steel differs from carbon steels. So, Eurocode 1993 Part 1.4 offer the supplementary rules for stainless steels. An alternative procedure have also been developed. However, research on conventional welded profile steel remain insufficient. As I said earlier, stainless steel differs from carbon steels in number of aspects, such as strain hardening, ductility, etc. The most important is the shape of the stress strain diagram. As for mechanical properties, stainless steel is nonlinear material which has a significant hardening and greater ductility. This is evident from the stress strain curve. Therefore, the design procedure for stainless steel cannot be simply identical with the carbon steel ones, and may also differ among the stainless steel families. The current Eurocode for stainless steel provides a simplified procedure for interaction factors, which has some drawbacks. However, the new version of the Eurocode is being prepared. It includes, among other things, new procedure for the interaction factors which were developed on the basis of research from the Imperial College. My experimental study consists of testing 18 beam columns. All specimens were made of austenitic steel, both conventional welded profiles and laser welded profiles were used. All specimens were loaded by compressor with range of initial loading eccentricities from pure compressor to 60 mm eccentricity. The specimen's geometry was chosen to cover cross-section classes 1, 2, and 3. The tensile coupon tests for every material and every plate thickness were performed following the procedure set out in standards. And the initial geometric imperfection were also measured. First, material tests have been performed to determine the mechanical properties of the material. For each tensile test, two strain gauges were used for a more accurate initial phase of the stress strain curve to determining the modulus of elasticity. The material properties are summarized in the table down below. Real structure steel members have initial geometric imperfection as a result of manufacturing and assembling process. The geometric imperfection can significantly affect the buckling behavior and also stability of slender steel members. Therefore, the initial geometric imperfection of the tested specimens were beforehand measured using two methods, namely manual measurements and laser scanning. Then the measurement results were compared. It can be seen that The laser scanner measurement contains some noise, but overall this curve matches well the manual measurements. During the experiments, two displacement transducers were placed at the mid-height of the specimens to measure the lateral deflection, and one extra was used to measure the out-of-plane displacement. In total, six tensile gauges were used for every test. Two strain gauges were attached near each end plates and in the mid-height of the specimens, always in the middle of the flanges. The reading from the strain gauges were used to determine the actual loading eccentricities. Additionally, the digital image correlation system or DIC system was used to obtain the whole strain field on the specimen surface. Knife edge were employed to achieve pin and condition about the major axis and fixed end condition about the minor axis. And lateral restraints were provided to all specimens to prevent minor axis deflection. It was important to provide lateral restraints, but at the same time to allow free slides, free movement in the direction of bending. So plastic pipes were used for this purpose. A numerical model was developed in the keyword edition of Abaco software. The shell elements were used for the numerical model. The boundary condition was set to simulate the knife supports of the experiment. So pin ended condition in the direction of bending and fixed end supports about the minor axis. Moreover, the eccentric reference points were offset from each end by 80 mm, simulating the distance from the specimen end to the knife edge, to the support in the test. All nodes at each end section were coupled with the reference points using kinematic coupling function. Initial geometric imperfections were incorporated in the model in the form of the lowest local or global eigenmodes with measured amplitudes. And the residual stress pattern was obtained from the literature was also applied to the models for conventional welded eye profiles and for laser welded eye profiles. That graphs show a comparison of the numerical model with the experiment. On the vertical axis is the force, on the horizontal axis is the horizontal displacement in the middle of the column. The blue line indicates the course of the experiment and the red dashed lines indicate the numerical model. Based on the graph, it can be said that numerical models match the behavior of the beam columns from experiments quite well. The results of all conventional welded specimens tests are given in the table, and also the test results were compared with the numerical model results. For conventional welded specimens, we can see that the model can be considered accurate enough. The mean ultimate force to experimental force ratio is 1.004 with coefficient of variation equal to 0.025, which is quite accurate results. However, in the case of laser welded specimens, this ratio is 0.94, so work on validating the numerical models will continue. And just to sum up, to date 18 experiments have been performed. The preliminary numerical model proved to be accurate for conventional welded specimens, and once again for laser welded specimens, the validation work on validation will continue. This research will also continue in a parametric study to generate beam columns data over a wider range of cross-section sizes, cross-section slenderness, member slenderness, and loading combination, and then the accuracy of existing design approach for stainless steel I-section beam columns will be verified. Thank you for your attention, and I will be happy to answer any question you might have.